morning, everyone.
Good
morning. Welcome to our service. Happy Mother's Day to everyone that a mom here today. And may you just feel blessed. I trust that there's been children in touch with you already and have communicated their love to you. And may you just sense that you are loved today. And we're glad to have you as part of our church family. And those that are visiting today, we just are glad you're here. And we also have a special visitor from the Pregnancy Center this morning. And it's Nikki Thompson, and she's going to share with us in a little bit. Of course, this is a baby bottle drive that starts on May, Mother's Day, and ends Father's Day. We've participated in that as a church for many, many years. And so she'll be sharing with us a little bit later in the service this morning. So welcome, Nikki, to our service today, and may the Lord bless you. All right, let's just pause and ask the Lord to minister to us this morning. Father, thank you today for the privilege of celebrating mothers. We pray today that as we participate in a service of worship, and we especially honor our moms today, we pray that you'll just pour a special blessing into their life. And Jesus will give you praise in your precious name. All right, let's sing this morning and stand as we begin to sing All My Life Long I Had Panted, Satisfied. All right.
All my life long I had panted for a drop from some spring that I hoped would quench the burning of the thirst I felt within. Hallelujah, I have found Him when my soul
their lives, we will have to say yes to the Lord Himself And so trust that that's happening in your life this morning. The other, just have a couple of announcements that I want to draw your attention to. First of all, there's a card here that we received, and it just says, "It seems that warmth and caring come naturally to you. There's a kindness that is genuine in everything you do. To the Free Methodist Church, thanks for being wonderful. Thanks for being you. And love, Alicia Castleman. Thank you all very much. I'm doing great." So Alicia has been a part of our prayer the last few weeks because of a surgery she was involved in, and we're just grateful this morning that she is doing well. A couple of other announcements that are in the bulletin. Just take note of our society information that's coming up on May the 16th, and we have a slate of nominees that will be coming forward for the positions. Again, you'll notice there's a couple that still need some attention from us as a church family, so be keeping that in prayer. On the back of that is the ones that are presently serving in those positions, so that just gives you an opportunity to make plans there. Also, June the 4th, Spring-O-Rama, it's happening at Wesley Acres. If you're interested in going, ladies, to that event, you need to really talk to Heather today so that you can get the registration in, and so that she can go ahead and get that taken care of. And gentlemen, if you're interested in fishing that day, I am planning to take the boat out and go fishing. So if you want to join me, again, I need to know so we can make plans for that day. The other announcements, I'm just going to kind of let you find them out yourself. They're in there for you. I will mention that the Lion King Jr. is being played at Maranatha Quinney Youth Unlimited. Again, this is a part of the Spirit Born. It's the junior group of the Spirit Born. And I know some of you went here a few weeks ago and saw the one that's put together every year. And so this is the junior group. And if you'd like to be a part of that, again, the information is there this coming Saturday on the 14th. All right, I think those are the announcements as far as we have that way. We do have a special presentation this morning that we're going to make before I ask Nikki to come forward. We have a special gift to give a mom here this morning. Many times when we give out gifts, we give out flowers and all those different things. Well, this morning we have a gift to give out, and you as a mother should have received a number when you came in. I'm going to ask Mary, what number are we picking this morning? And if she can tell me, what number is it, Mary?
Eight.
Number eight. Oh. Who has number eight? Oh, all right. This is Alexander. Happy Mother's Day. And we want to present to you a Happy Mother's Day gift this morning. All right, and happy Mother's Day to you. And this is awesome. We also have other gifts for moms as you will leave this morning. First of all, thank you for the ones that have been able to participate in the pictures of your mother and you or your family or however you made that mix. And if you've not had a chance to look at the back table here by the nursery window, make sure you do that before you leave this morning. And we will encourage everybody, please take your picture with you as you leave this morning as well. So we're not chasing you all week to make sure you have it. But there is a special gift for all moms this morning. As you leave today, you'll find on a little pegboard back there on the window by the nursery, pick one of those welcome signs and take it home with you. That's for you today. And we're glad that you're part of our church family. Just honored to be the pastor of so many moms this morning. All right, Nikki, I'm going to have you come this morning and share with us about the pregnancy center and the bottle drive.
Good morning.
Good morning.
So my name is Nikki Thompson, and I'm here from the Pregnancy Center in Belleville. And I have to say, I'm really excited to be back on behalf of the center, because I started way back in 2006 as a volunteer, and that was in Belleville. And then in 2008, we opened the Prince Edward County Pregnancy Center, and I was able to serve as a director there until 2013. And then I had my baby girl. And so I stopped serving there and started serving her. And then my second baby girl came in 2017. And now that they are 9 and 4, which is hard to believe, I can come back. And now I am serving again in Belleville as the Women's Program Director. And so I'm pretty excited to be here again. And you are, I have notes because you are my very first speaking engagement since I've been back. So A, I'm nervous, and B, I think I'm gonna forget stuff. So I have to have notes this time around. It's not just coming like it used to. So now I get to talk to you about great things like our baby bottle drive and tell you a little bit about what we do. So first, I just wanna say thank you. I know that your church has participated for years with the baby bottle drive, and we really appreciate your support. So thank you for participating again. And it's kind of funny, I look back here and I can just see the baby propped up in the background where the bottles are sitting. So thank you for participating yet again. And every year, as you know, from Mother's Day to Father's Day, we distribute hundreds of bottles throughout the community so people like yourselves can fill it with change over that time, or cash, or a check, or whatever you like. And it's all in support of the center. And so it's a great little way to keep us going. This year we have two ways that you can support. One is virtually, which is just by going on our website and going to, which is at BPFCC. Oh, I should have said that. I'm not sure if you know what says that. The BPFCC, Belleville Pregnancy and Family Care Center, bpfcc.ca, and clicking on our donation button. Or if you're super techie and you have a smartphone, we have a little poster back there with a QR code, and you can just scan it and it'll take you right there to the donation form. I would not be using that option. I am not a super techie. And the second option, of course, is to take a baby bottle today, take it home, and from now until Father's Day, fill it with your spare change or cash or check, whichever is easiest, and then bring it back on Father's Day and we will collect it then. It's that simple. So, as you know, all of us face challenges. I just wanted to share a little bit about something that happened in the last couple weeks. I had a young couple come in, quite young, and they are currently facing an unplanned pregnancy. And the young woman was so worried, and she's just scared and worried because she has no idea what to expect. She has no idea how she's gonna get through this. And she's, you know, just rather terrified. So I was able to sit with them and share with her how we are here to walk with her every step of the way from before and after the birth of her baby. And so after telling her about some of our programs and different things, I've got her signed up for our prenatal program so she knows what to expect. I've got her signed up for our grandmother's heart program, so that's when people come in and help afterwards and after the baby's born. And then a little bit in the future, she's going to join up with our parenting program, which was pretty exciting. And then the young man, who had been sitting there throughout the whole visit looking rather stunned and shell-shocked, I'm pretty just numb, I think. He was visibly relieved to know that we had support for him also. He thought it was all about mom and all about babies, but it's also for him, and we have support for him also, and we got him signed up for our dad's program. And it is, I have to tell you, it is amazing to be able to share with these young people, or anyone that is struggling, and that this unexpected pregnancy is a big deal, and they're nervous and they're scared, and then they realize you can just watch the fear and anxiety leave them as they realize they're not doing this alone. They have help, and we're gonna be here every step of the way. And so it's really a blessing. That young lady actually left smiling and a little bit excited. And so it was such a change from when she came in that I was feeling very blessed that day to have been able to serve them. And we're gonna continue to serve them for quite some time, I'm sure, and we're pretty excited about that. I'm not sure if you know, but in Canada, almost half of pregnancies are unexpected. So that is why we exist, right? The Belleville Pregnancy and Family Care Center. We exist so that no person needs to face these challenges or unexpected pregnancies by themselves. They have someone to walk alongside with them and give them a hand. So we provide support, education, and resources, giving accurate information, compassionate care, and hope to those we serve through our programs, such as the ones I mentioned, the prenatal care program, the grandmother's heart program, our dad's program. We also have a program that goes into the schools talking about healthy relationships and sexual integrity, you know, so they don't have to come to the center, try to get them first. And although we don't provide for or refer for abortion, we are there for them to provide compassionate care for someone who has gone through an abortion, and we give them a place to share their grief and their loss and maybe offer some healing for them. We've also expanded our capabilities through a Christ-centered video program called Bright Course, which includes a wide variety of videos we use to supplement our existing programs, like the ones I've just mentioned. We have over 200 videos now through this program that allows us, we can send videos and worksheets. We can use them in the center with our clients, or we can send the videos and the worksheets, we can text them or email them directly to the clients, so they can complete the work, watch the videos, and do everything at home if they can't make it in. And on our end, we can see what they're doing. We can see how much of the video they've watched, so they can't cheat and tell us if they watched it. If they didn't, so you've only seen 2 minutes, you keep going. Or they've got their worksheets, and I can see if they've completed their worksheets, and then we make a follow-up appointment. But it really is good, especially, you know, in the last couple of years where people weren't going anywhere, and we couldn't get, but they still need help. And so this has been a really good added bonus, it's a good tool for us to be able to use when somebody can't come into the center for whatever reason. We can still offer some help and support and talk to them and get them some healing and some help that they need. I should say too that the videos are they're produced containing Christian principles, so they offer a spiritual content that if anybody is open and willing, we're able to speak into that and share the hope that we have in Christ, and hopefully they will also find that hope in Jesus. And the videos are all vetted by professionals in the field, so we don't really have to worry about what we're sending out there. It's all been good and done. So it's a really great new tool. So today, I'm not gonna go on too much about our programs. I think you know a little bit about us. And if you do have any questions or anything, I will be here at the end. I'll maybe stand at the back there by the bottles and you can ask me. There's brochures and things back there too if you wanna know more about our programs. Or if you'd like to volunteer, we are always looking, and we're always open. I have little pamphlets there. You can let us know. So if you have any questions or anything, I'd be happy to talk to you afterwards. So today, when you take a bottle or scan the code to give, you're giving hope to many vulnerable young women and men in our community that have the potential to face or are currently facing an unplanned pregnancy, as well as those who need healing from maybe a past abortion experience. And with that hope that we share comes Jesus Christ as well. And so I just want to thank you again so much for your participation in this fundraiser that we have and for being a longtime supporter of the Pregnancy Center. Thank you very much.
Up to date on some of the events that are happening there, and as I was sitting there listening to the hope that Vicki was sharing with us about this young couple that's just come in, think of the battle that's raging in the U.S. over the abortion issue, and even today some of the churches are being targeted for being against abortion. And here we have a local pregnancy center that's stepping in to a situation where very easily it could have been a decision to have not to had the little one. And so thank God for his work, amen? And may we ourselves be available to those that have either walked through those situations or are there when we're needed. All right, we're going to sing another package of worship. These songs, as we picked them out this morning, This particular next song is not a typical song that you would sing as a congregation, but it's a song that has a great message for moms today. And so if we don't get all the timing right, if we don't get all the words in there, I do want you to leave with the message, because the message is for you this morning. All right, let's stand together as we sing.
Footprints that we leave, lead them to believe.
The pregnancy center and what the work that they're doing in our community this morning, and we pray that you remember Nikki and Thompson and her staff and those who work with her and the other members of the pregnancy center that work there on that street. And we just pray, Lord, that you'll continue to multiply over and over again these young couples that'll come in and seeking help and not knowing where to turn. And yet, Father, we're thankful this morning that they can always turn to you. There's nothing in life that we can't put into the hands of God. And we pray today especially for this young couple that's coming even this week. And Lord, that you would pour your blessings upon them. And Lord, that you would encourage them to find their peace with you and allow your spirit to work in their heart and life. And bless those that give leadership there this morning, we pray. And Father, we again thank you for the blessings that you've bestowed upon us as a people. Thank you for your hand upon those that have been suffering illness in the last little while. And we pray that you'll continue to minister to them this morning. And Father, we just commit this service to you. May it be a service that bring honor to your name. And Lord, may it be a service that brings honor to our moms that are present here as well. And Jesus will give you praise. Amen. You may be seated. All right, we have a special number of song this morning. Elaine's going to come and share with us some music today.
Good morning.
The song that I'm singing this morning, I first heard it by, I guess it's the Tally Trio, and it kind of touched me, and so I wanted to share it with you. I feel like I'm singing in my boots, but it's a beautiful song that it was his life for mine. How could he save a wretch like me?
His heart was broken, mine was mended. He became sin, now I am clean. The cross he carried for my burden, The nails that held him set me free. His life for mine, his life for mine. How could it ever be that he would die, God's son would die, to save a wretch like
expected to speak about a mother of which I have never lived, never been a part of. Oh, I have had a very good mother, and I have had a good wife that's been a good mother, but I've never been a mother. So take what I have to share with that knowledge, but I trust that God's Spirit will minister through His Word this morning. So I thought it'd be fun. I always enjoy beginning Mother's and Father's Days with little sayings that come from our children. because sometimes they speak volumes of truth. So maybe there's a little nugget of truth in one of these little sayings that you just need to go home with, okay? Maybe that's all that you'll get today. But here they are. These are some of the reactions of a child that says, "My mom's the best because. I love her because she gives me hugs and kisses and cereal and is beautiful as a shooting star. And she tells me to be careful wearing socks on the stairs. You could slip. I love that my mommy hugs and kisses me and that she takes me to fun places. My mommy taught me that my family and my friends are the most important things in the world, so I want to be a great friend to everybody. My mom always helps me and she taught me not to play with sharp knives. My mom always tells me not to wait until the last minute on my homework. And it's good advice. She makes Play-Doh with me and stays home with me during the day so she can play. And she tells me to wear my helmet when I ride my bike and my scooter. My mom taught me to listen, respect, and do the best you can. My mom likes my mohawk, and she has a blog. Now, if you don't know what a blog is, find somebody with a computer and type in there, blog. She works really hard to take care of us, my brothers and me, and then she works just as hard to make other children healthy too, and she told us to wear sunglasses when we chop up onions. I love her athlete. How do you pronounce that? There you go. You got it. And her silly voices. And she always tells me to be nice to my brother because then I can achieve peace. I'll never forget some of the advice we gave Heidi. Someday your brother will be bigger than you. That proved to be very true. I like when my mom buys us gelato for a weekend treat. She taught me to tell people you love them right now when you feel it. Are there days you don't feel like it? Moms, have there ever been days that you questioned your love for that little brat running around the house? As I've been thinking and praying about this day, I've been drawn to thoughts about how can a mother's impact the lives of her children? And maybe we should clarify that. How can a mother impact the life of a child in a very positive manner and in a way that they will seek out God in their life? We all know as a mother, whether you're a good mom, a bad mom, or a so-so mom, or whatever kind of a mom you are today, you have impacted your child's life. There's no question about that. You will always have an impact there, whether it's good or whether it's bad. So let's turn to a couple of scriptures that I think speak to this, and let's look at it for a moment. 2 Timothy chapter 1, verses 1 to 7, we'll read that one first, and then a second one we'll go to is 1 Samuel chapter 1. So let's read this one together. So Paul, an apostle of Christ Jesus by the will of God, according to the promise of life that is in Christ Jesus. To Timothy, my dear son, grace, mercy, and peace from God the Father and Christ Jesus our Lord. I thank God, whom I serve, as my forefathers did, with a clear conscience, as night and day I constantly remember you in my prayers. Recalling your tears, I long to see you so that I may be filled with joy. I've been reminded of your sincere faith, which first lived in your grandmother Lois and in your mother Eunice, and I am persuaded now lives in you also. For this reason, I remind you to fan into flame the gift of God which is in you through the laying on of my hands. For God did not give us a spirit of timidity, but a spirit of power, of love, and of self-discipline. Now we'll go to 1 Samuel chapter 1. Start in at verse 9. So 1 Samuel chapter 1, start at verse 9. Once when they had finished eating and drinking in Shiloh, Hannah stood up. Now Eli, the priest, was sitting on a chair by the doorpost of the Lord's temple. In the bitterness of soul, Hannah wept much and prayed to the Lord. And she made a vow, saying, O Lord Almighty, if you will only look upon your servant's misery and remember me, and not forget your servant, but give her a son, then I will give him to the Lord for all the days of his life, and no razor will ever be used on his head. As she kept on praying to the Lord, Eli observed her mouth. Hannah was praying in her heart, and her lips were moving, but there was a voice that her voice was not heard. So Eli thought she was drunk, and said to her, how long will you keep on drinking, or getting drunk? Get rid of your wine. Not so, my lord, Hannah replied. I'm a woman who is deeply troubled. I have not been drinking wine or beer. I was pouring out my soul to the Lord. Do not take your servant for a wicked woman. I have been praying here out of my great anguish and grief. Eli answered, well, go in peace, and may the Lord of Israel grant you what you've asked of him. She said, may your servant find favor in your eyes. And then she went her way, and she ate something, and her face was no longer downcast. Early the next morning, they arose, worshiped before the Lord, and then went to her home at Ramoth. Elkanah lay with Hannah, his wife, and the Lord remembered her. So in the course of time, Hannah conceived and gave birth to a son. And she named him Samuel, saying, because I have asked the Lord for him. Now when the man Elkanah went up with all of his family to offer the annual sacrifice to the Lord and to fulfill his vow, Hannah did not go. She said to her husband, after the boy is weaned, I will take him, present him before the Lord, and he will live there always. Do what seems best to you, Elkanah, her husband told her. Stay here until you've weaned him. Only may the Lord make good his word. So the woman stayed at home and nursed her son until she had weaned him. And after he was weaned, she took the boy with her, young as he was, along with a three-year-old bull and an ephah of flour and a skin of wine, and brought him to the house of the Lord at Shiloh. When they had slaughtered the bull, they brought the boy to Eli. And she said to him, as surely as you live, my Lord, I am the woman who stood here beside you praying to the Lord. I prayed for this child, and the Lord has granted me what I've asked of him. So now I give him to the Lord. For his whole life he will be given over to the Lord, and he worshiped the Lord there. As we pause for a moment or two this morning, and celebrate this incredible day, Mother's Day, I want to just simply remind us, mothers will impact the lives of their child. Part of who you, your children are this morning is because of what you have invested in them. Sometimes I like the statement, you're like your dad. Or you're just like your mom. Now, sometimes that statement can have a little negative connotation. You know, you're acting just like your father. And I've had it said to me that way sometimes. But then sometimes, you know, we've also said, you're just like your mom. How can that influence be at its best in our life? Well, I have some thoughts that I want to share with you. First of all, your faith makes an impact. Your personal faith with God, or lack of faith with God, makes an impact on your child. Don't you love the statement that Paul makes to Timothy? He says, I am reminded of your sincere faith, which first lived in your grandmother, Lois, and then in your mother, Eunice. And I'm persuaded now lives in you. Moms, grandmothers, do others see your faith in the lives of their children or grandchildren? How we live out our faith and our walk with Jesus has the potential to be seen by others in generations to follow. I think a perfect example of this is my grandmother. When she came to know the Lord, she was older in life. She was battling and struggling with the enemy one day at the kitchen sink. Have you ever talked to God at the kitchen sink, Mom? Yeah, I'm sure you have. My grandmother was standing there at the kitchen sink. The Spirit of God was dealing with her heart and said, Eliza, you need to follow me. You need to turn your life over. And Eliza, my grandmother, said, but Lord, if I turn my life over to you, this will be a lonely journey. I will be the only one that will follow you. And she sensed in her spirit that the Spirit of God said to her, if you will follow me, there will be four generations that will follow you. And that's proven to be true. So friends, this morning, moms, today, your faith makes an impact. Many times I felt like the fact that our families live so far apart, we have a harder time making an impact sometimes. To be honest with you this morning, I envy you that have your children close by. I do. Oh, I'm not supposed to envy, am I? But I do. In some ways. I hope it's the good way. Because they're right there. Faith is a daily thing that you live and experience with them. But friends, this morning, even if they live at a distance, we have opportunity to invest in their life in some capacity. Whether it's a simple birthday card, whether it's a simple phone call, or if you're computer savvy, it can be a face-to-face. I find it fun sometimes when I have on my phone a little app called Duo, and so I connected it to family members, and so as long as I'm in a Wi-Fi connection, I can actually flip that phone on and call them, and I can see them face to face, and that's an awesome privilege to do that. But moms, this morning, even across the miles, even though they may separate you today, I still encourage you to find ways to impact a child's life. It may just be as simple, I'm praying for you. It may be a simple, I love you. It may be a simple encouragement card, a little gift, whatever it may be. But oh friend, oh moms this morning, take that time to let them know about your faith. A second one that I think of this morning is your prayers make an impact. Do you notice the story of Hannah? She had been praying before the Lord for multiple years, over and over again. And even the day that she was praying in such agony, she was accused of being drunk by a priest. Can you imagine that? Coming in, being under such a burden to be accused of that. But moms, our children need your prayers today. Are you praying not only for your children, but what about your grandchildren? In some cases, some of you have great-grandchildren. Are you praying for those children today? Pray that a child's heart will be tender to the Lord. Pray that God will give them discernment and recognizing truth, knowing what is truth. Pray that God will give them boldness to live out their faith. We're in a generation that to live and be a Christian, you will have to live in the boldness of Christ. Pray for the protection from the attacks of the enemy, those subtle attacks that come in that many times we don't recognize until we're already in the situation where our life is in turmoil. Pray for the growth of the seed of faith that's planted in the child's heart. In a congregation this size this morning, I'm well aware of children who are not following in the steps of faith that you as mothers have traveled. Keep praying. Keep praying. Year after year, Hannah came to the house of the Lord to pray. As she agonized in prayer, she had even been falsely accused, but she kept praying. Mothers, your prayers will and do make an impact. Keep praying while God keeps moving in the lives of our children. Many a son or a daughter or a grandchild will point back to a praying mom as their means of coming back into a right relationship with God. Mom, pray for your kids. They need your prayers this morning. Here's another one. The mother of impact surrenders her children to God. Hannah stands before the priest Eli and God in the temple, and she says, I prayed for this child, and the Lord has granted me what I've asked of him, so now I give him to the Lord. For his whole life, he will be given over to the Lord, and he worshiped the Lord there. We purposely sang the song this morning, I Surrender All, for a purpose today. I'm sure this morning that we have mothers that are sitting under the sound of my voice today that need to pause this morning and surrender your child to the Lord. Some have children that are wayward this morning. Some of you carry that burden today. If there's a child of yours that's outside of the ark of God today. They're going their own way. They're doing their own thing outside of God's will. Mom, surrender that child to God today. Some this morning are in a broken relationship with a son or a daughter. You need to surrender that child to God today and do everything possible to mend the brokenness this morning. God is still able to do the impossible. Some have children that are sick today, that are ill. It's not a natural thing for a child to die before a parent. That's totally unnatural for us. A friend, mother this morning, released that child into God's hands. God does do things well. We can trust him for that. So release that child into God's hands. Some have children whose marriages are struggling today. They need an intervention of God. May we release that into God's hands today. Pray God will bring people into their lives to help them sort out the differences of life and get on the same path. Some have children this morning that are without work today. They're having a hard time. They're struggling. Can you release that to the Lord this morning? The heart of a dedicated, loving mom always wants the best for their child, right? But there's sometimes you and I have to take our hands off. Stop trying to manipulate it. Stop trying to work it out. And just take your hands off and say, Lord, I present my child to you. I don't care if they're 5 years old or 55 years old. There's sometimes we have to take our hands off. God loves your son, your daughter, your grandchild more than you could ever love them this morning. I don't care how deep you think your love is. For God so loved the world, he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believes in him need not perish but have everlasting life. So take a moment this morning and surrender your child to God today. As we close this morning, I thought it'd be good for us to sing a couple of our songs, portions of our songs again this morning. The first one is we're going to sing the first verse of I Surrender All. So as a mom today, take this moment and whatever is going on in your child's life that maybe you'd like to have a little bit of say in it, you'd like to put your input in it, your direction, you know the best, just take your hands off of it for a minute and surrender that child to the Lord this morning, or grandchild, or whoever it may be that represents that person in your life. And just physically do that this morning. Lord, here is, and name him by name, and surrender him to God today. And then we'll end with that little chorus, You Keep Praying. Because I'm convinced this morning that the prayers of a mother are incredibly powerful. And I believe this morning that as I look back in my life, it was a praying mom that helped us as kids get on the right track of life. And I'm convinced this morning that even though my mom has been gone for a number of years now, Scripture tells us that her prayers have been bottled up and they're being poured out today. So I'm convinced this morning that even though mom may not be physically with me today, there are prayers that she's prayed for my life and for my children's life and my grandchildren's life. And if I live to be old enough to have great-grandkids, her prayers will still be poured out for those that have come behind. And may God help us that those who are coming behind us will see the faithfulness of our walk and know Jesus, the author and the finisher of our faith this morning. Let's stand together as we sing these couple of songs. Take your time getting out. You're not in a big rush today, I don't think, are you? Anyway, take your moment and pick up your gift at the back and your baby bottle as well. All right? Bless you.